All right, Eric, today we're going to work on adding fractions, okay?
Okay.
All right, so, but we're going to focus on adding fractions with different denominators. All right? Can you think of two fractions with the same denominators?
One-fourth and three-fourths.
One-fourth and three-fourths, good. So the bottom number or the denominator is the same, right?
Right.
So can you think of two fractions now with different denominators?
5/5 and 6/3.
6/3, 5/5 and 6/3. All right, good. But so when we add fractions with the same denominator, it's easy, right? So if we look at the fractions 3/7 and 2/7, we can just add the numerators, right? Or the top numbers.
Right.
Right. So what are the numerators here?
The numerators are 3/7 and 2/7.
So the numerator is the top number, right? So what's the top number in this one?
The top number, the numerator is 3, and the numerator for the other one is 2.
2. Good. So what is 3 plus 2?
5.
5. Awesome. So we put a 5, and then the fraction bar, and then what's the denominator?
The denominator is a 7.
7. So the 7 just carries over into the answer, right?
Right.
But when we have fractions with denominators that are different, we have to take a couple of steps before we can add them, okay?
Okay.
All right. So let's look at the steps here that we have to take. So when we're adding fractions with different denominators, the first thing we do is we're going to model the fractions, and then we're going to find multiples of the denominators. The third thing is we determine the lowest common denominator. Next, we determine how many new sets of each fraction you need and make them. And then the last thing is you add.
Okay.
All right.